He transported more than 80,000 black Africans from Bristol, from Africa, to the United States and the Caribbean. 10,000 of those slaves that Colston transported died on the voyage in those ships that Bob Marley sang about, those slave ships. Now, the big question, as I said in my introduction, is why there was ever a statue to a slave trader in Bristol in the first place. Certainly in modern times, seems inconceivable that you would commemorate such a man. But when you look more closely, practically everything in Bristol is named after Edward Colston because, of course, like many a magnate, he donated a small portion of the profits that he had made from the blood of the Africans to good works in his home city of Bristol. There's not just a statue. That building behind the statue is named after him. There's a grammar school named after him, a girls' school named after him. There's parks named after him. And of course, he was just one of the slavers who built their entire financial empire on the enslavement, brutal killing, torturing, and enslavement of black African people. So don't act surprised if in the middle of a wave of protests against racism, against black people, that the statue of a slaver ends up in the drink, the very drink that, as I said, he once made foam with the blood of black Africans. But of course, it's not just Bristol. It's not just Bristol and Liverpool. It's not just Bristol and Liverpool and Glasgow and London. The British Empire was built on the enslavement of Africans.